archaeology, especially Maya archaeology in Guatemala, they do a lot of tunneling into the temples, and they unearth different types of things, and they want to be able to measure those tunnels and the things that are in those tunnels, so masks or steps or other artifacts of the temple that they're tunneling into. And so we've done a good amount of work on trying to create accurate 3D models of that using different types of technology.
The first technology we deployed was just LiDAR. We also used structures from motion, the stationary LiDAR and structures from motion. They're good technologies, but can we do something better? Can we give more real-time feedback?
I started looking at 3D scanning technology, mobile scanning technologies, and how I could apply them to the Maya archaeology project particularly. That was my first experience with E4E. It was also like the first time going, you know, into the jungle, the first time going in an archaeological site, and well, that was amazing.
So I'm in El Diablo at the entrance, and I'm gonna start mapping the tunnels.
Spiders everywhere. I've seen some rats in the tunnels before. I saw a snake, a big black snake in one of the tunnels. Bats as well. The heat is also pretty bad. Lighting is an issue, I think, a lot with, especially when you're trying to create the 3D models.
Those excavations can be very complex as we dig narrow tunnels following remnants of ancient architecture, and they're very difficult to convey to the public. And the 3D modeling helps us do that, and it helps us visualize what we're doing and makes us really think about where we're going to dig next. So it's valuable both from a technical archaeological standpoint, but also from a sort of public dissemination standpoint as well, and really being able to convey the results of what we're doing here at Els Oaks.
It's hard to explain what it's like there, but I think with as you can present these models, and if you could sort of do, you know, almost like a game where you're walking or crawling through these tunnels, I think that would give people a lot of understanding of what it's like to do archaeology.